great man, and we're very happy to have had him here. We're very sad to see him leave. Thank you, Ross, for coming. Thank you guys so much for being here.
Thank you, Patrick. We'll start, and then I'll say a couple of words about our program.
Thank you.
So that particular song, Sangha Chatvam, is from the Rig Veda, one of the ancient books of Hinduism. The text is probably 3,000 years old, but this particular tune is from the first part of the 20th century, a tune given in Bengal, the state within India that I'm from. We're going to stay with our sort of prayer song theme and go even deeper into the Rig Veda for a very famous Sanskrit song, the Gayatri Mantra. You'll notice throughout the evening, if you stay with us for the whole time, that we have an amazing embarrassment of riches in one area. For the first time in probably Auburn's history, we actually have four competent tabla players available to us, and they actually have all made it here today.
Oh.
Thank you. As we go through the program, I'll introduce you to various members on the stage. That treatment of the Gayatri Mantra combines a more traditional tune, which we did in the beginning without the rhythmic accompaniment, had a different, the Gayatri meter is actually prevalent in that, and then combined that with a more kind of modern treatment where the drums came in and had a more catchy beat. Because if you want the masses to sing an ancient liturgical piece, you need to give it a catchy tune, and so that's what the Sanghi did. On the tabla, on the very first piece, and he's back on the next one, is Dr. Amaya Kalarkar, Physics Department at Auburn. And then you just heard on the Gayatri Mantra piece, Amritsa Dattar, who is also a faculty member in consumer design. On the sitar, to my far left, Zachary Watson, undergraduate student, and in his third year, I think, maybe fourth year. Yeah, started in fall 2012, actually, the first video I found of Zach with us, so it's been a while. We have several old friends of the ensemble in the audience. Very happy to see them here as well. So one of the things that we're going to try to do today is just to give you a smattering of many different pieces that we've done. We're going to be changing scales and changing moods through different rods. And that's very difficult to do because part of the charm of Indian classical music is to really build up a mood and get you into a certain pattern of notes and intervals of notes. And by all this jumping around, it'll take us a second to recalibrate ourselves to the different rods. Thank you.
Thank you.
So the solo piece in the middle of that was by Mike Watkins on a non-Indian instrument, that's the Turkish saz. And Mike just joined our ensemble this summer, and so this rock pipe is one that we've been learning this summer. I spent the last class yesterday, so I guess it's either learned or never going to be learned. It fit very nicely with some Arabic music that he knew, and so we asked him to play it. Very nice, thank you. Really interesting. So now we're going to take a break from the vocals. We're going to skip ahead by one in your program. And we're going to have a sitar tabla duet. So the fourth tabla player that you're seeing tonight, Sam Price, Auburn, Alabama, is going to play a few compositions with Zachary. Thank you.
Thank you. behalf of the Auburn Ensemble and the Cultural Music Society, we'd like to award Dr. Raj a few things for being such a wonderful teacher and mentor over the last 3 years.
It's his best. So we're going to adjust a few things in the program. We were pretty ambitious in terms of what we wrote down, what you have in front of you. We're going to go back to the second item under classical songs, Raghu Bali, and then we will go, and after that, we're going to finish out our classical section. So we'll do Raghu Bali and the Auburn song, and then we'll finish out our classical section with the very last item in the classical song section, which will give us a transition from what we call purely classical into some semi-classical. So we'll finish up with Raag Mesh and Eshu Shamala Sundara, a song by Rukunata.
The mic's right there.
Sa
show you that you can do Indian classical music with lyrics in any language, right? And so that was in Rakupali, and we did a very typical type of fast melodic runs with those words. Auburn is a really lovely place, really lovely place. Dear Tigers, thank you for such a lovely music day. So now we have to switch moods again to a rag called Ragdesh. So we're going to stay with this fusion of Rabindranath's music with others, and we're going to move into our semi-classical and folk section of the program, and we're going to start out with a song. Dottie will sing the English version that Tagore then adapted beautifully to Bengali with the same, almost the same tune.
Another Bengali speaker from my hometown, Calcutta.
PhD student in math, and he's been able to join us when he's able. So sometimes you do songs with certain students because they just love a particular song, they fall in love with the song, and then they insist that you have to do it. And so then the reward that they get, of course, is they have to sit right next to you in the front row and make sure everybody hears them. So we're going to do the next song, it's Alo Amarado. I think Rasika danced, or learned to dance to the song when she was very little. Yes. And so when she finally discovered that the song was actually just a divorce song, she actually learned that. She had no idea what the lyrics were, right? We were learning to dance. so we're going to do it. Thank you. finish with two crowd favorite, hand clapping, feet stomping type of songs. So please feel free to clap and stomp along these ones. The first one is a song by Qazi Nazrul Islam, who is a national poet of Bangladesh, wrote in the language of Bengali. And it's, if you've heard us over the years, we've done this with many, many different iterations of this ensemble. It's called Shukna Patar Kurbai. And we're going to work in our Middle Eastern instruments with the song. And then we'll finish off with a chatka, which is a folk song from Bangladesh, from foothills of Bangladesh, a farmer's song, which I think you'll enjoy as well.
Thank you.
So, and for Achen on the tabla, fantastic. Okay, so we're going to finish off with a song called Allah Make Day. Allah Make Day, Allah Pani Day, Allah Chaya Day, Allah Pani Day. And it's a farmer's song. The heat, the sun is beating down mercilessly, and it's a plea to Allah for water from the sky, for shadow, from some relief from this unbearable heat. Amrut and Sam will be the main percussionists on this.
Thank you.
Susan on vocals, Joita on vocals. We had Mike on saz. We had Shamok on mandolin. Zach on sitar. Dadi and Rasik on vocals. Thank you very much. See it, so we just wanted to make this a joyous musical celebration. So thank you all for